Brother, we're not the Christian church. We're not out here to get numbers. We are here to save souls. It's not about numbers. It's about real men of God.
I'm going to show you what the Most High told us to do on the Sabbath. Give me Luke 14 and 20. What you're doing right now is what the Most High commands each and every Black, Hispanic, and Native American man to do. We are out here raising up the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
Which are you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans? Read that.
No, we're the propitiation of our sin.
And he is.
Jesus Christ is the propitiation of our sin.
That's right.
Bring it up.
So that's the kind of nonsense we're talking about. Of God.
The what?
Oracles of God.
This Bible was only given to the children of Israel.
That's right.
It was not given to any African. It was not given to any Egyptian. Give me Psalms 147, 19 and 20. Because according to the Bible, we are at the bottom of society because we do not keep God's law, statutes, and commandments.
That's right.
It is high time that we wake up out of sleep.
Neither keep they the king's law.
And they don't even keep the king's law. Because guess what? Just because the so-called white man says Sunday is the Sabbath, we say, no, that's not true. The Sabbath is on Saturday, and we're going to keep it on Saturday.
That's right.
And we're going to write up a written document saying I'm not working on the Sabbath. Because we're different from everybody else. We're not going to do what everybody else. We're not going to sing and dance like the white man has told us to do for over 400 years.
As many years you've been lied to, y'all can look around and see the state of our people. No matter what we do, we cannot seem to get out of this captivity, out of this mental bondage, after this physical bondage. Our men are getting killed dead in the streets, but yet there is no change. Why is that? Because we are consistently breaking God's laws every day. But today is a new day. Give me that.
John chapter 8 and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. All right, what is God's truth according to his holy word? What is it? Because y'all can say, oh, I'm going to church Sunday. The pastor's preaching a good sermon. That's the truth. What's the truth, brother? What's the truth? What is the truth of the Bible? I'm asking you.
Ask somebody else.
What about you, brother in the suit? Him. Yeah, him. Hey, brother. Brother.
These brothers. What about this brother on the phone? We are paying attention.
Give me what the truth is according to the Bible, officer. Give me Psalms 119, 142.
Psalms chapter 119 and verse 142.
This is the truth according to God's holy word. Give me that.
Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth.
So God's laws is the truth. God's laws is the only thing that's going to get us out of this captivity. Believe it or not. That's the only thing. Give me Romans 13 and 10. Give me that. Live honestly. Give me that. Because the state that we're living in, the things that we're doing is wrong. It is sin according to the Bible. All right? This is what we're supposed to be doing. Give me that.
Romans chapter 13 and verse 10. Love worketh no ill to his neighbor.
Read down. I want...
Yeah, there you go.
Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantoning.
So it says, walk honestly in the day. Walk honestly, having a good conscience to God. Read.
Not in chambering.
Not in sexual immorality. Read.
And wantoning.
Uh-huh.
Not in strife.
Not in strife. Not being jealous of one another.
Right.
Not wanting to sleep with another man's wife.
That's right.
Not wanting to join us on his feet. Not being covetous against your own brother. Read.
And envying.
And envying. Hating on that dude. Hating on that female. Read.
But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ.
But do what?
But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
And make not provision for the flesh.
And make not provision for the flesh. Give me 2 Peter 2:20. Instead, put on Jesus Christ. What example did he leave for us? What example did Jesus Christ leave? Give me that.
Chapter 2 and verse 21.
Uh-huh.
For even there are two where you call, because Christ also suffered for us.
All right, so Christ suffered for us. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Right.
That's why we out here. We not at Florida State. We not in the suburbs. We come out here for y'all.
That's right.
Whether you want to hear it or not.
Right.
Read.
Leaving us an example.
Christ left us what?
An example.
Read.
That ye should follow his steps.
That we should follow his steps. So when Christ walked the earth, what did he do? Read.
Who did no sin.
Who did what?
Who did no sin.
Read.
Neither was guile found in his mouth.
Neither was guile found in Christ's mouth. That's why we out here. Because y'all didn't know that Christ was your own kindred. Y'all didn't know that Christ looked just like y'all.
That's right.
That's the problem with the black man, the Hispanic man. We have identity crisis. We can't relate with this Bible because y'all think everybody in it is white.
Right.
But that's Bible prophecy. But look at you. Y'all out here cooning on the Sabbath day.
Right.
Y'all out here in the corner store on God's holy day that he set up for y'all.
Right.
Not the white man. Not the African. Not the Chinese. For you. For y'all. Give me Hosea 3 and 4. Hosea 3 and 4. Y'all don't know that Christ is your brother. Give me that.
Hosea chapter 3 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
For the children of Israel shall abide many days without a king.
Without a king. Read.
And without a prince.
Uh-huh.
And without a sacrifice.
Read.
And without an image.
Without an image. Who here can show me what Christ looked like? Who out here? Who can show me what Christ looked like according to the Bible? Go and give me what Christ looked like, officer. Give me, start at verse 13.
Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 13.
Uh-huh.
And in the midst of seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot,
uh-huh,
and girt about the path with a golden girdle.
All right, so the vision was that John saw the Son of Man, which is referring to Christ, Jesus the Christ. Read.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So Christ's head and his hairs were white like wool. We are out here speaking to people with woolly hair. Why is that? Because Christ looked like y'all. That's why we out here.
Right.
Read.
As white as snow.
As white as snow, read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire. And his feet like unto fine brass.
And his feet like unto fine brass. If your feet are brass like color, which is brown, read on.
As if they burn in a furnace.
So not only did it start off brown, it got darker.
Right.
Because it was burned in the furnace. So what that mean? Christ was a so-called black man.
That's right.
From the tribe of Judah. But y'all didn't know that. Give me Amos 8 and 11. Y'all didn't know that. Because this knowledge, this was taken from our people.
Right.
We were robbed and spoiled because we transgressed God's laws. Give me that.
Amos chapter 8 and verse 11.
Uh-huh.
Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land.
A famine in the land. A famine is a drought. A famine is a lack of. But what is it talking about? Read.
Not a famine of bread.
Not a famine of bread. Not physical bread that we eat. Read.
Nor a thirst of water.
Nor a thirst. touch the water, read.
But of the hearing of the words of the Lord.
But what?
But of the hearing of the words of the Lord.
That's why y'all never heard this before. That's why you have no connection with the Bible.
Right.
Because we were put on slave ships. Our nationality was stripped from us.
That's right.
Give me Jeremiah 17:4.
Our nationality got stripped from us. Then we were called African Americans, blacks, Afro Americans, Negroes, niggas, every name except who you really are.
That's right.
Give me that.
Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4.
Uh-huh.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage.
You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans would discontinue from your heritage.
That's right.
And I'm looking at it today. Y'all don't know that this is your book. This is your book. This ain't the white man's book. That's what you gotta understand. This is your history. Read it again.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
From thine heritage that the Most High God gave us. How would he do that? Took our Bible away. Give me Isaiah 29:13. And then our oppressor, the so-called white man, he taught us our own book. But he taught it the way he wanted to teach it. Now, he's God's chosen people. And now we're Gentiles. And y'all got your Christian pastors every Sunday getting on the pulpit teaching y'all this every day.
Right.
That's why y'all in this state y'all in. That's why when you see your brother, you hate him.
Right.
That's why when you see your sister, all you want to do is have sex with her.
Right.
And you don't care because you don't give a damn about your people.
Right.
That's what's wrong with us. Read.
Isaiah chapter 29 and verse 13. Wherefore the Lord saith, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth.
That's the Christian church right there. A lot of people, the same people on the block right now, they gonna be in church tomorrow morning. Read it again.
Wherefore the Lord saith, for as much as these people draw near me with their mouth, and with their lips do honor me, but have removed their heart far from me,
uh-huh,
and their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men.
Taught by the precept of men. What men? The same men who put us in chains. Give me Deuteronomy 28:68. Slavery is in the Bible.
That's right.
Our history is in the Bible. Deuteronomy 1:1 and then Deuteronomy 28:68.
Deuteronomy chapter 1 and verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Unto all Israel. So that's why we out here. We're gonna show you the words that's speaking to you. Brother, what's your nationality? Black. Is that in the Bible? Is it? No. All right, we'll show you, brother. Give me that. Give me Deuteronomy 28:68.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
So God will bring the Israelites, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, into captivity again. With what?
With ships.
Just in case you think this is my words, give me Exodus 20:2. Because we must study precept upon precept.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2.
So this is going to show us what Egypt means. Read.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Read.
Out of the house of bondage.
So Egypt means bondage, captivity, slavery. Now let's go back to Deuteronomy 28:68.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68.
Read.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Into Egypt again, read.
With ships.
With what?
With ships.
That is the transatlantic slave trade. For you blacks, so-called African-Americans, West Indians, Haitians. Read it again, officer.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again.
Uh-huh.
With ships.
with ships. So we would go into slavery again with ships. That's in the Bible. But y'all didn't know that. Read.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
Thou shalt see it no more again. Pat the camera. I think it's funny. As soon as the Bible come out, the block clears. Our people hate God's word.
That's right.
There were brothers were swarming on the block just a few minutes ago. Once this Bible came out, they said, I got to go. That's the problem with our people, man. And we got these slack leaders in our communities keeping our people asleep.
Right.
Give me 48 and then 64.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 48.
Hold on. Sis. Hey, sis. Can I talk to you for a second? Can I share the word with you for a second, sis? Give me the scripture.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemy.
Because of hard-headed Negroes being rebellious against God's word.
Right.
We will do what?
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemy.
That's why the white man is ruling over us. Because we don't want to hear God's word.
Right.
Read.
Which the Lord shall sin against thee.
Don't think the white man has any control. God is doing this for a reason.
Right.
Because you are hard-headed and you're rebellious.
That's right.
You hate to hear what's right for you. You want to do what you want to do. God says we can't do that. And if you do, he said he gonna put you to death for it.
Right. That's right.
Read.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall sin against thee.
Read.
In hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things.
So in anything we want, food, clothes, shelter, water.
Look at them flickinaries. Look at them flickinaries.
Anything we want, we have to go to our enemies. We can't do nothing on our own because we broke God's commandments.
Right.
So now we serving our enemies. Jump down to verse 64.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 64. And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people.
The Lord shall do what?
And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people.
Why did he do that? Give me verse 15. I'll be coming right back.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 15.
Why did God scatter us amongst all people? Why would God do such a thing to the people he say he loved? Read that.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice.
Sis, you know what your nationality is, sis? You know? All right, read that.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Most High God scattered us with slave ships because we would not hearken to what he said. Go back to 64.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 64. And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people from one end of the earth even unto the other.
Read.
And there thou shalt serve other gods.
And when we get to these other places, we shall do what?
And there thou shalt serve other gods.
We shall serve other gods. We will bow down before these pagan gods. The white image of Christ. The white image of Christ didn't come about to the 1400s. So what does that mean? It's false.
Right.
It's false. It's part of religion. Give me Colossians 2 and 8. That's what y'all got to understand, man. This Bible does not support Christianity.
Right.
That's right.
Christianity is of the devil.
That's right.
Thus saith the Lord. We're going to show you that. Give me that.
Colossians chapter 2 and verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
Read that again.
Beware.
Alert. Alert. Danger. Danger. Warning black man. Warning Hispanic man. Read it again.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
Philosophies and vain deceits. getting your doctorate in biblical studies, going to theological school, going to the seminary. Read it again.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
So I see y'all never read that scripture because you're gonna be in a Sunday church tomorrow.
Right.
Read it again.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
Through philosophy and vain deceit. Deceit that has no profit, no benefit for you, black man. Why in the hell would you bow down to your oppressor?
Right.
Why would you do that?
Right.
That's foolish. What's wrong with y'all? What the hell is wrong with us?
Bring it out.
Read it again.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
Read.
After the tradition of men.
After who?
After the tradition of men.
Of men. What men? The white man.
That's right.
I'm not scared to say it. Your damn oppressor, the white man. Read.
After the rudiments of the world.
After the rudiments of this wicked world. Read.
And not after Christ.
And not after who?
And not after Christ.
Not after Christ, the black Messiah.
That's right.
Give me Ephesians 4. Because Christianity is nothing but division and confusion. There is only one way. Thus saith the Lord. Give me that.
Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 3.
Bring it out. Y'all not used to a man of God speaking real with you. Y'all want somebody to tell you God loves you. God hates y'all.
That's right.
Because you living in sin.
Right.
I'm going to tell you like it is. Hold up. Give me Psalms 5 and 5 real quick. Y'all think I'm lying. God hates you in the state that you in. Give me that.
Psalm chapter 5 and verse 5.
Read.
The foolish shall not stand in thy sight.
The foolish is those who forsake God's commandments. Read.
Thou hatest all workers of iniquity.
God does what?
Thou hatest all workers of iniquity.
So if you're living in sin, God hates you. Go back.
Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 3. Endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace.
Endeavoring to keep the unity. There ain't no unity in Christianity. You got Church of God in Christ. You got Baptists. You got Methodists. You got Seventh-day Adventists. You got Roman Catholic. You got all these sects and divisions in Christianity. But what does the scripture say?
There is one body.
Read.
And one Spirit.
One Spirit.
Even as you are called in one hope of your call. One Lord.
One Lord.
One faith.
One faith.
One baptism.
Go back to one Spirit.
There is one body and one Spirit.
One Spirit. What is the Spirit? Why haven't your Christian pastors taught y'all this? What is the Spirit? Give me that.
John chapter 6 and verse 63.
Read.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
Read.
The flesh profiteth nothing.
Uh-huh.
The words that I speak unto you.
The words that Christ spoke. Read.
They are spirit.
Read.
And they are life.
They are life. The words, they are life. Give me Proverbs 7:2. The words, they are life. That food, you can eat that all day. Eventually you gonna die though. These words is gonna make you immortal. If you decide to apply them, give me that.
Proverbs chapter 7 and verse 2.
Read.
Keep my commandments and live.
Do what?
Keep my commandments and live.
Keep God's commandments and live. Keep his commandments and live. Because food, you can eat it. You'll get full. You'll get hungry again. But it says what?
Keep my commandments and live.
Give me Matthew 4 and 4. Because this is the word. This is the nourishment. This is that bread. This is that water that you need.
That's right.
Give me that.
Matthew chapter 4 and verse 4. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone.
Read it again.
But he answered and said, it is written.
Listen up. Listen to this.
Man shall not live by bread alone.
Man shall not live by just bread alone. Whether it be pizza, whether it be dinner rolls, whatever it may be. Read it again.
Man shall not live by bread alone.
Read.
But by every word of God.
But by every word of God. By every word of God. But what has failed us is our leaders.
Right.
We don't have righteous leaders. That's gonna be an example to our people. Give me Ezekiel 13:1. We don't have leaders that's gonna stand up against the workers of iniquity. Give me that.
Ezekiel chapter 13 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel.
It says what?
Prophesy against the prophets of Israel.
You so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The Bible said prophesy against these false leaders. Read.
That prophesy and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own hearts.
Out of their own hearts. That's the problem. That's the problem. What is, give me Proverbs 3 and 5. We'll be coming right back. It says they prophesy out of their own hearts. What's that telling you? That it's not of God. They say what makes them feel good. Read that.
Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Do what?
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart.
Read.
And lean not unto thine own understanding.
Lean not into your own understanding.
Right.
Go back and read that. Was that verse 3?
Ezekiel chapter 13 and verse 2. Son of man, prophesy against the prophets of Israel that prophesy, and say thou unto them that prophesy out of their own heart.
Out of their own hearts. Jump down to verse 10. What do they say? Read that.
Verse 10. Because they have seduced my people, say, peace. And there was no peace.
What did they say?
Peace. And there was no peace.
Peace and there was no peace. Barack Obama is your president, which is a Hamite anyway. But he said change, change. But things have gotten worse for the black man in America.
Right.
I ain't never seen that many black men get gunned down in the streets day after day after day.
That's right. Now,
read it again.
Because they have seduced my people, say, peace, and there was no peace.
Peace? Where the hell is the peace? Where's it at? Where is the peace? Read.
And one built up a wall, and lo, others daubed it with untempered mortar. Say unto them which daub it with untempered mortar, that it shall fall.
That it shall fall. What is Martin Luther King's quote? He said, right before he died, he feels like he integrated his own people into a burning house.
Right.
Because he said, I have a dream. He said, key word was I. He didn't say, thus saith the Lord. He
right.
said, I have a dream.
Right.
That little black boys and white girls can be holding hands. No, that was his vain vision. You know what? That was Gandhi's vision.
Right.
Martin didn't even have a voice of his own. That's what I'm talking about. We got slack leaders who have led our people astray. It's high time that we wake out of this sleep.
That's right.
Give me Psalms 94 and 16. We are fishes of men. Who is going to say enough with this captivity?
That's right.
Give me that.
Psalms chapter 94 and verse 16. Who will rise up for me against the evildoers? Who will rise up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Against the workers of iniquity. Who's going to rise up? Is it you, brother? Who's going to rise up for the Most High Christ? Against the workers of iniquity. Give me, Psalms 38:18? Iniquity. Yeah. What is iniquity according to the Bible?
Psalm chapter 38 and verse 18.
Uh-huh.
But I will declare mine iniquity.
Read.
I will be sorry for my sin.
So it says iniquity is sin. So who out there is going to rise up against sin? Anybody.
maybe y'all don't understand that you're actually living in sin.
Right.
So that's what we're here for. Give me 1 John 3:4.
Bring it up.
What is sin according to the Bible?
1 John 3:4.
Uh-huh.
Whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law.
So this is sin. So just in case you wanted to know what sin is, listen up. Read it again.
Whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law.
Read.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
Sin is the transgression of the law.
That's right.
All right, give me Exodus 20:8.
Exodus 20:8. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day.
Stop. Give me Nehemiah 10:31. So the scripture said, 6 days, Sunday through Friday, you're supposed to work, do all your labor. All right? But the seventh day, which is today, God's Sabbath, you ain't supposed to be doing what you want to do. Give me that.
Nehemiah 10:31. And if the people of the land bring any ware or victuals on the seventh day to sell, that we would not buy it of them.
That we would not what?
That we would not buy it of them.
So should this store be open right now? No. Read it again.
And if the people of the land bring any ware or any victuals on the Sabbath day.
Today's the Sabbath day. Read.
On the holy day.
Uh-huh.
That we would not buy it of them upon the Sabbath day.
We can't buy or sell on the Sabbath day.
That's right.
That's in the Bible. So that's a transgression of God's laws. Give me Isaiah 58. Do no pleasure. Do no pleasure on the Sabbath. You can't do what you want to do. You can't post up on the block just doing what you want to do on the Lord's day. He made this day separate from every other day.
Right.
Isaiah 58:13. If thou turn away thy foot from the Sabbath, from doing thy pleasure on my holy day, and call the Sabbath a delight.
And call the Sabbath a delight, read.
The holy of the Lord, honorable, and thou shalt honor him. Not doing thine own ways.
Not doing what?
Not doing thine own ways.
Going to a football game. Read.
Nor finding thine own pleasure.
Doing what you want to do on God's day. Read.
Nor speaking thine own words.
So y'all got to understand that. This day ain't like every other day. It's a sign between us and the Most High. The children of Israel and God. We're not like everybody else. We cannot do what we want to do. We can't follow the white man. We can't follow the African. We ain't them. We God's people.
That's right.
Read that.
Exodus 31:16. Wherefore the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations. For a perpetual covenant.
For what?
For a perpetual covenant.
How long is perpetual? Perpetual means forever. Read.
It is a sign between me and the children of Israel.
Hey, brother. Hey, bro. Hey, what's your nationality, man?
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, Please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.